Ukraine, where politics has become the administration of economics, an underlying tension separates the structured social body with its politicians and what Jacques Rancière, the French political philosopher, calls the path of no path. Groups, causes and interests, radically excluded from the social or political order, which must change the rules of political and social visibility in order to be heard. When this tension between the organized social structure and that excluded part unexpectedly erupts, then it becomes what Alain Badiou, the French philosopher, has called an event. Every social and political situation includes different classes, groups, people, interests, and ideologies. But in the midst of these differences, there is a void which supports the stability of the totality. It lies closely to the most anonymous and the most vulnerable. The December insurrection disrupted this settled state of recognized difference by performing this void of the socio-political situation. What was invisible, unspoken and unspeakable came to the fore. In this sense, the insurrection as event is the performance of the political assets. The people did not say, I want this or that, but simply, here we are. Here we stand against. Not I claim this or that right, but I claim the right to have rights. We, the nobodies, the school kids, the unemployed and unemployed, are everything. Indeed, only yesterday we heard that 33% of Greek youth between the ages of 18 and 24 are unemployed. So what they said in 2008 and what they're saying today, that we, the supposedly apolitical, voiceless, indifferent nobodies, are the only universal against those who have always interpreted their particular interests as universal. The eruption into visibility of groups, interests, and individuals who had been left outside the social contract shattered the facade of unity and homogeneity. Something similar happened to individual consciousness and identities. People reported experiencing an unprecedented, draining, almost uncanny set of emotions. The great symbolic institutions work before we desire their mastery and their law. An event happens when the dependence and fear sustaining the symbolic order cracks, in Jacques Lacan's terminology, when the big other is seen as an imposter. In an atomized society, symbolic power relies on our acceptance of superego's obscene demand, enjoy your submission, enjoy your freedom to choose. When courage as bravery, endurance or modern knowledge breaks through, we become momentarily our fate's masters. Athens 2008 marked a change in the political imaginary and prepared the protests we now witness. Before the political insurrection, political change was a matter of consensus and policy. After the rift, politics changed through the appearance of new subjectivities, the eruption of the political into ordinary politics, and the rearrangement of the rules of political visibility. The essence of the event is precisely this loosening of sovereignty. Sovereignty as the fetishistic and performative whole over the collective and the individual. This is carried today. These revolting kids are the postmodern descendants of Socrates. Thank you.